Chess is split into three phases: the opening, the middle game, and the end game. While the opening can be very fun to study, as you can choose the positions and kind of build the game up on a way that you want it to, you should also study the end game. Even though it might seem very boring and mysterious, you should absolutely study it. Why? Because the end game is solved, which means if you were in a winning position and you knew the ways of winning an end game, then you would 100% of the time win. And say you were in a losing position and you knew the ways of drawing a game, then you would take that draw, obviously, because draws are a lot better than losses. Half a point is a lot better than having no points. And in this video, I'll be covering one of two parts of queen and pawn endgames. Now, in the last video, I did king and pawn endgames, but now we are going to be doing queen and pawn endgames. And now, in this position, you might be saying, the king, black's king is pretty screwed. And you're absolutely right. Black's king is going against the queen, while all he has is a pawn. And in this position, for white, all we want to do is basically get this queen to this square, to basically be in that pawn's face. And when pawns are not too close to promoting, when they're not on this square, when they're not one square away from promoting, this can be very easy. And luckily for us, we can do this in two moves. We can go to c2, and you might be asking, well, black's pawn doesn't have to progress so fast. Can't the king just protect it? No, because in this case, the queen attacks all the squares that the king can go to protect the pawn. He cannot go here, and he cannot go here, because the king is occupying those two squares. So if he was to go here, then you would get in front of that pawn, and no matter how hard black's king tries, he will never be able to attack the queen, obviously, because the queen attacks all sides, and you can never get close to it if the queen is just stuck on your pawn and doesn't make it to move. And no matter what the king does, you'll get to a position where your king is right beside this pawn, which will make it free to the taking. But this is basically the basics of it. Now let's head on into a harder position like this one. In this position, our pawn is not two squares away from promoting, it is now one square away from promoting. And in this case, we have to be very, very, very careful, because one blunder can make our queen, their pawn available for promotion without any harm. And now in this case, all you want to do is basically keep checking the king. Say you go to h6 and check the king. And now if he was to go to d3, then you go back to c1. Which, again, we are brought back to this position where he cannot protect those two squares because the queen is attacking both those squares. So black is again screwed. You get in here. Oops, sorry. You get in here. And then you get in his face. So instead of going to d3, you can go to d1, which is a lot safer. And do not, I repeat again, do not go to h1. Why, you may ask? Because the black's pawn can go down, block that check, and promote to a queen, which will end in a most likely a draw, probably. So do not, I repeat again, do not let your queen check the king where the pawn can protect the check and block and promote the square. Now, a check that doesn't let it block is d6, which checks it, and say the king goes to c2, and now in this case, you want to get close to the pawn and the king, so you go back to c5, he goes back d1, check, he goes here, and now you are on the $1 million square. Why, you may ask, this is a $1 square? Because no matter what black does, in the next move, he has two decisions to make, right or left. Now, if he was just to go left, then you take the pawn. It's pretty easy. But if he was to go to e1, which is exactly what you want him to do, then you push your king. And say he was to go to f1, well, wait, before I explain, Why you may push the king? Because the pawn cannot move and promote it. So you're not really in much danger, as he cannot move because it is blocked by the king. But now he can move. So you kind of have to check again to make this king get in front of this pawn so he cannot move. So f3 can do the trick. Again, if he goes to g1, then you just take the pawn. But say he was to go to e1. And then again, you advance, and you're gonna get to a point where it's gone like this, and it is white to move, and you just, well, easily checkmate them. And that's basically how you win an endgame. You have to be very, very careful with these checks, as I explained again. One check can be the outcome of your game, of it being a blunder, and you being in a draw, where you were in a winning position, which is obviously very sad. Why would you want to be in a draw when you have a queen and the opponent has a pawn? But yeah, that is how you, that is basically the full basic of how you would protect do a queen and pawn endgame. But before, I actually forgot to mention, but let's go back to our main setup. It was like this. Now, I forgot to mention, I was supposed to say this in the beginning, but this is actually very important. The placement of the pawn is very important, and you might be asking, why is it very important? Well, because say the pawn was on the A file, then it would actually be a draw. And say the pawn was on the bishop file, which is the C file, so A, then it would be, again, a draw. Now, say he was on the F file, which, again, is another bishop file, then, again, it would be a draw. So, if the pawn was on the A file, the C file, the F file, and the H file, which is a rook and bishop file, all two rooks and all two bishops, then it will most likely end up in a draw. If black's king plays perfect play, or if your opponent plays perfect play, then it is most likely going to end up a draw. And now in this case, it is not in those squares. The squares that will most likely be a win for white, if you play with perfect play, which is the B file, the D file, the E file, and the G file, which is a knight file, and then a king and queen file, then you would most likely win. And let me actually explain why the rook file and the bishop file is most likely a draw. Now, take this position, for example. The pawn is not on the E file, it is now on the A file, on A2. And you might be saying, well, what's so different? You know, a black's pawn is just one square away again from promoting. Well, the difference is that if we keep checking, say if the queen was to go to B6, and the king was to go in front of the pawn to A1, you might be saying, ha, we've got him in front of the pawn. Now the pawn can't move, and now we can forward our king. But you're actually pretty wrong, because if you were to forward your king, then it would be a draw, as the queen covers the only exit that the king can go through. So if you were to move your king, and it was black's turn, he cannot go here, because the queen blocks those squares, which will end up in a draw, which is a sad blunder for white. So basically, black has a pretty strong drawing wall. And even if if you don't push your king, say instead of moving the king, you again try to check him to get into a way where the queen is not on this file and doesn't block all its remaining squares. Say he was to go to b2, and you get closer, and then he goes back again, you get closer, blah blah blah, you go again, but you can see again, even if you do get closer, it is a draw. It is a sad draw. Say he was to go to here, say he was to go here, and here maybe, then again, it would still be a draw, because there's no way in this position that you can, no way in this position where it can kind of look like this, because Black's king will be in this little corner where he can just hide himself, and which will somehow end up in a draw. And it is a very, very sad day for White's queen, as it's kind of failed. It is not a winning position for White if the rook if the pawn, sorry, was on the rook file. And let me explain now why it would be a draw if it was on the bishop file. Now, in this position, the pawn is not on the e file, it is not on the rook file, but it is on the f file, which is a bishop file. And you might be confused a bit on why this is a draw, because say black was to go to f1, he still has two choices to make. But you're kind of wrong. Say he was on back to g2, and we went to check him. And say he goes to g1, not f1, because again, then you just progress your king, and that wouldn't be such a smart move for black's king. Say you check him again, he goes to h2, and you go on that $1 million square where he's kind of screwed. But he actually kind of isn't. If he was to go to g1, then you go to g3, and now he has a tough decision to make. If he goes here, then you might say, wow, I can take it. That's a really easy pawn taken. It's a very easy position for me. But you're actually wrong, because in this position, it is white's move, and if you were to take, then it would be a sad draw for black's king, as if it was black's move in this position, he cannot go anywhere. He is blocked, and obviously in chess, it is a game where one person has to take one turn, and then the other one has to move another move, and blah, blah, blah. And in this position, you cannot skip a turn. Obviously, you can never skip a turn in chess, and this will be a sad draw for black's king. And even though he was to go to f1, which will be a blunder, obviously, because if he was to go to h1, it will confuse white's queen, which will put it into the draw. And obviously, as I said before, draws are what you're fighting for if you're in a losing position, because if you know that there's no way in life that you're going to win that position, then fight for a draw. You know what I mean? Like, don't straight away resign. Fight for that half point instead of getting 0 points. Say you're in a tournament and you need like a half point to win, and you were in a losing position, then find a way where you can make that draw and get that half a point. Obviously, because draws are half a point, wins are 1 point, losses are no points. But anyways, but yeah, this was one part to a two-part series of the queen and pawn endgame. But yeah, as I was explaining, rook files and bishop files are draws, are big draws. And if it was on the B file, the D file, the E file, the G file, which is a knight, a queen, and a king file, then it would be most likely, with perfect play, a successful endgame for white. But in some of these cases, it'll be a draw. And this is why you should take in endgames to consideration. This is why endgames are solved, and some outcomes of these endgames will make you sad, and some outcomes will make you happy. Yeah. This is my queen and pawn endgame. This was a 1-2 part series. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. I always appreciate a like if you liked the video. And I always appreciate some constructive criticism if you want me to build up on anything. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. And as always, have a nice day.